Hey everybody, my name is Ted Schaeffer. I'm the chair of urology at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. And I wanted to just start with an interesting case that we had recently come through my clinic. And it highlights a lot of new and emerging things that we're seeing now in the workup and diagnosis of prostate cancer. So the case is a 74-year-old man who had a rise in his PSA to around 9.5. He had a prostate biopsy and he was diagnosed with unfavorable, intermediate, and high-grade prostate cancer. And as part of that workup, he got really kind of state-of-the-art imaging for staging. And as most of you guys know, that includes a PET PSMA. And he came in with his family. He was very upset because he was told that he had advanced prostate cancer. And so I said, well, let's just, you know, examine him and so forth. We reviewed over his MRI imaging, which looked okay, and also looked at the report from the PET scan, which was on an outside facility. And this was a PET PSMA scan. And it demonstrated that he had adenopathy in his right axilla, or right armpit. And so I just told the family, look, let's just get the images. Maybe we'll review them in our multidisciplinary tumor board, and then we can circle back with you and figure out what's going on. And so this is actually a picture of really the key image for this particular gentleman. This is an axial cut. And what it shows is this suspicious lymph node right here on his in his right chest wall. And when we showed this image, our nuclear medicine physicians, you know, they really picked up on it right away. And this to them was a very classic case of embolization of the PET tracer agent from a right-sided or right-handed IV administration of the agent. So when you give the PET agent, it's given in a bolus. Some of it can extravasate, and some of it can go to a local draining lymph node of the right arm or the left arm if it's given that way. And so this was very common to them. They're individuals who obviously review PET scans all the time. PET PSMA imaging and imaging with PET scans and prostate cancer is a much newer thing. So it was great to have a great group of radiologists who are comfortable reading PET scans tell us, no, we most likely think that this is not a lymph node involved, but this is actually just an artifact of the administration. So what we did for this gentleman was we actually just were able to get a repeat PET scan approved, and we did that. We did an injection site on the left hand this time, and we saw no lymph node here in the right axilla and no lymph node on the left axilla. So this patient went on to have surgery, and everything went well, and at 3 months follow-up, his PSA is undetectable. So point of the story is we do have great new emerging imaging technologies, but the technologies are only as good as the individuals who read them and interpret them. We have a great team here. It was a great pickup, and I thought it'd be a fun case to put online because I think as urologists and radiation oncologists who are using these types of images much more in their practice today, it's good to know about these potentially this kind of a variety of false positive cases. Thanks very much.